In this video, I will talk about what display rules are and the different types available. I will list the different display rule levels and then focus on the report level for today. Display rules allow you to conditionally highlight data that meet defined criteria. You can define display rules for report objects at the report level, table level, graph level, and gauge level. In this video, I will be focusing on the report level display rules. There are three kinds of display rules, but not every level supports all rule types. The first one is expression. This is based on a measure data item expression, and it accepts numeric parameters. Next, we have color mapped values. This is based on a category data item value. And last is the gauge. This is based on a measure data item interval definition. Here is a summary of the supported combination of display rules and type. In this video, we will be looking at the report level display rule, and we can see that the only type supported is the color mapped value. Why use a report level display rule? Here are some reasons. First, to be able to quickly assign colors to category values across the entire report. Second, to be able to comply with corporate or brand requirements. And third, and maybe the most important when telling your data story, is to have consistent colors for category values across multiple pages regardless of prompt selections and filters. For example, if you had a report looking at holiday decor sales and you wanted to add meaningful color, which color mapping would you pick? Most people associate certain colors with holidays, so I would guess that the colors on the right-hand side resonate with expectations. You would want this color assignment to remain consistent throughout the report, and we can achieve that with report-level display rules. Okay, now that we know why we would want to create a report-level display rule, let's talk about some implementation specifics. The rule essentially reads like a Boolean expression, where for the return data for the report object, it checks to see if any category in that row equals action figure, and then if it does, if it's true, style it purple. Else, check to see if any category in that row equals game, if it's true, then style it green, so on and so forth. A few points to keep in mind. The report level display rule is applied to all applicable objects in all pages of the reports. This is not tied to a data source or a data item. And finally, if multiple display rules are defined for an object, then the object level display rule takes precedence. Let's dive into the demonstration. This is available for SAS Visual Analytics version 7.5 and greater. Let's take a look at the report. I'm going to go ahead and select the list table object, and we can see that the data source driving this object is the Megacorp data source. In fact, for all three of the first pages of this report, they are all using the Megacorp data source. Let's go ahead and define a report level display rule. Using the right-hand pane, I'm going to go ahead and select my Rules tab. We can see right now I have the list table as the active object. I'm going to use my dropdown and select the very top level, which is the name of the report. And here we can see I'm now at the report level. So let's go ahead and select New Rule. And notice that I'm not selecting a data source or a data item. A display rule at the report level just means we're going to define category values and assign a color. So let's go ahead and start typing. It has autofill typing against category values associated in the report. So the first one I'm going to type is action figure. And I'm going to go ahead and just use the value that comes up. And for action figure, we want to color it purple. I'm going to use the add. The next one we're going to type is game. go ahead and select the value that comes up, and game is going to be green. Use the addition, going ahead and type promotional. Promotional is going to be blue. And last, we have stuffed animals. And we are going to style it yellow. So again, this report display rule is going to be applied or trying to be applied at every object. Each object will incorporate a report display rule level differently. Let's go ahead and click OK. We can see instantly that the report level display rule has been applied. Sometimes the formatting of a report level display rule is not ideal, and again, you can assign an independent object level display rule to overwrite any report level display rules. But we can see now how all of the values are colored the same in the list table, the bar chart, and the line chart. Let's go ahead and pay attention to the colors. We can see I have open here in the display rule. So if I start using the button bar at the top to filter, no matter the order in which I have, here I do have all four. Let's take a look at the north region. We can see I only have action figure and game, but we can see that the colors still remain consistent. If I go to south and west. So again, this is the power of the display rule, that no matter what filtering or prompt selections we have applied, those colors for those category values remain the same. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the crosstab, pie chart, and tree map objects. Here we can see right off the bat that the crosstab object does not participate in applying report level display rules. Here we can see that we do have the pie chart that participates, so we do see the report level display rule being applied here, and the tree map. Looking at the roles pane for the tree map, if I had a color assignment added, which I'll go ahead and do that now, we can see that the report level display rule is now no longer applied. It doesn't make sense when I have the color role assigned for this particular object, because in this case now color is meaning something different. Here it's meaning the how much revenue is being brought in. If I remove the color role, we can see that the report level display rule is once again applied to the tree map. Now let's take a look at the key value and geo map. I think this is another great example of how to use color and see the connection quickly between the two visualizations. It's very easy to see which key values map to the geo pie. Again, using the key value, just going to the options to show you, the default coloring for the measure value is the default that was selected. So these colors are not individual. This is with a lattice role assignment for product line, and the report level display rule is actually what is coloring the key value in this case. And also with the geo pie, we can see that I have the facility city, and then I have my pie expense and by product line applied here. We can see if I did not have a report level display rule, these would be the default. Again, remember, why is this so important? This is because once I start filtering, those values, again, the color values stay the same across no matter how many or what the subset of a product line is, it all stays the same. Finally, in the multiple data sources tab, this is where it's pretty powerful. So remember that all of these three pages are being driven by the Megacorp data source. Well, now I have the inside toy data source. When I click on this bar chart, we can see I'm using the inside toy data source. And in this bar chart for the cars, I'm using the cars data source. Now, again, let's just pop over to our display rules tab. So here at the report level, for any category that has this value in the report, remember, it's not tied to the data item or the data source. So while this does remain initially product line values in Megacorp, we can see that Inside Toy has something called a game. It does happen to be product line. Now, to show how this is really applied, down here in the bottom two bar charts, I created custom categories where I renamed some of the values of either product line or type. And we can see that if the value in the display rule is there, it goes ahead and colors it appropriately. So again, this is just showing you the power of a report level display rule, that it's not tied to a data source and not tied to a data item. For additional resources, please refer to the SAS documentation or my four-part blog series. And thank you, and check back with the Technical Insights and Expertise series for additional tips.